Researchers have set up a system that lets them see mutations in living cells and follow the cells' fates. Good, bad, or neutral, spontaneous mutations are not easy to detect in a living system, but there are important unanswered questions about how mutations are distributed and how common they are. This information makes it possible to use the mutation rate of organisms to look back in time to see when two related species diverged. In this view, the mother cells are along the top of a microfluidic chip, so named because narrow channels control the liquid's flow in very specific ways. The offspring bud off and expand into the tiny tubes, each cell pinched off from its progenitor. Newly made cells are whisked away by liquid at the bottom of the tube. Bacteria are red, and replication error machinery, markers for mutation, are the yellow dots. The researchers followed bacterial cells over 200 generations to look for mutations and the effects those mutations had. They were able to calculate the rate of deadly mutations at about 1%, much lower than expected. They also found that mutations occur regularly in individual cells. They all get mutations at pretty much the same rate, regardless of stress level, and that mutations are less detrimental to the bacteria than expected. This new technique for tracking mutations in single cells could be used in cancer research or to explore different mutation patterns in different tissues.